Like, I want to show you why Facebook ads are going to do more for a business than a Super Bowl. So let's just theoretically get into this.
If you're serious about building a brand, it's a year by year. Billion-dollar businesses actually have been built already on the back of just social media.
The Super Bowl. Every year we get this hype, we get this crazy energy, everybody's watching it, especially if you're American. I mean, Americans love their football, but even here in Canada, everyone was watching it. I just witnessed dozens of Super Bowl parties happening everywhere I went. Everyone was talking about Super Bowls. The roads after the game were busy. Twitter was lighting up. Instagram was lighting up. All this hype around the Super Bowl, but there's only one thing that I can actually think about. When I watched the Super Bowl, the only thing I was thinking about the whole time was the advertising. These crazy ads that everybody looks forward to every year to see what are they gonna come out with. And there's a crazy thing about them. And what I wanna kind of go through today is, before I break that down, why Facebook ads actually outperform and are a better ROI than Super Bowl ads. Like, I wanna show you why Facebook ads are gonna do more for a business than a Super Bowl. So let's just theoretically get into this. Let's assume your business, your small business, whatever, can get an ad on the Super Bowl, right? That costs anywhere from $500,000 to $1 million, sometimes more, for a 30-second video. 30-second ad, $500,000 to $1 million, okay? That's gonna be seen by, what? A few million people, let's say. Let's make all things equal to make this make sense. Let's assume it doesn't cost $500,000 or $1 million. Let's assume the ad just cost you $100,000. And let's just, for argument's sake, say that 100,000 people watch it. So I'm reducing everything here, but just to make sense of it. You somehow get your local small business on the Super Bowl for 100 grand, okay? Here's what happens. Your 30-second ad is gonna run in front of all these people. Now, most people on the commercials are either A, already too drunk to care, B, start turning to their friends, talking to them about what just happened to the game, or C, they get up to go pee. Like, that just being realistic, that's what happens. So your ad comes on and 90% of people stop watching. So let's say there's that good 100,000 out of everyone that was watching that day, a good 100,000 are actually watching, focusing on the ads. And obviously I'm reducing here because I'm also reducing the cost. And let's say that cost you $100,000. So what did you just get? You just got $1 per person to watch your video. And this is massively reducing because you'll never get a Super Bowl ad for $100,000, obviously, right? But let's just say you did. $1 a person to watch your video, okay? This is a random person, completely cold audience. You might be selling, you know, a beer that's supposed to be for millennials, and a 78-year-old retiree is watching the ad. So this is 100,000 completely random cold people, may or may not know your brand, may have no need for your brand, and you just paid $1 per person. And then what? Nothing. They see it and it's done. Money burned. Now, on Facebook, what's really cool, what's really different about this is we can do the same strategy. I can put you in front of the exact same amount of people. We can put you in front of 100,000 people, and guess what it's gonna cost? $1,000 on average. I can put you in front of 1 million people, it'll cost about $10,000. Give me the same $100,000 that you spent on the Super Bowl ad, and what can we get you in front of? Right? About 10 million people. 10 million people for the 100,000 instead of 100,000 people. Now, what does that work out to? We get views on our videos on Facebook ads for an average of 1 to 3 cents per view. So the same concept as the Super Bowl, we'll get the, they're still the same people. Whether they're watching the Super Bowl or they're in front of their computer, it's the same kind of people, right? But better, and I'll tell you why. But you're gonna get them to watch your video for 1 penny to 3 pennies. That's your cost. The only difference is they'll be targeted. You'll get to actually choose who sees it. So it is the right age demographic, it is the right interest base, it is the person that could actually buy from you, and it's gonna be 1,000 times cheaper, right? So it seems like a no-brainer. It gets better. Not only do they see your ad and go away now, which would have already been a win and more efficient than a Super Bowl ad, but you can retarget those people that watch that ad. So they see your ad that only cost you a cent to get them in front of. They go to the bathroom, come back, load up their phone, and there's another ad from you with an offer. So that same company they just saw, well, now they're getting retargeted with offers 24/7 until they buy things. So imagine if somehow, if this was Super Bowl world, that would be like getting a Super Bowl commercial for the equivalent of $1,000, but making sure everyone who saw it was your actual target demographic, and then being able to reshow ads to everyone who watched your ad. That's what Facebook is doing, if you're following me on this. But to bring it really clear and summarize that, if you spend $100,000 on a Super Bowl ad, and 100,000 people watch it, you have 100,000 cold audience members that will probably never buy from you and they'll never see you again, and you have no data. You spend that same $100,000 on Facebook, you reach 10 million people and have a pool that was targeted, so you hit 10 million of the right people that you can now keep their data forever and retarget them with offers anywhere, anytime, any place that you want, right? But yet, people are still falling all over these Super Bowl ads. Why? I don't know. But I know for a fact that these huge companies that are running Super Bowl ads are now looking at 2020 and 2021 to allocate massive portions of their budget straight to social media, because this is finally clicking in. It's just that they're slow. They're big organizations. They take a long time to move. Whereas in your case, you're not. You're a small business. This is logical. So have comfort in the fact that when you run Facebook advertising the right way, it's a lot more efficient, a lot cheaper, a lot better result than a Super Bowl ad. So what I just told you is basically the average small business has the power of a Super Bowl ad to run a Super Bowl ad in your city, your province, your state, your country. You can get everything that that gives you times 10 for a tiny fraction of the cost. That's the power of Facebook ads. It just makes sense, but businesses are still not doing it. So hopefully you watch this and this makes sense and you actually take this, apply this in your business, do something with it, try it out, search for more information. I'm just telling you, the truth is here. Use it. It's not going to be this easy forever.